New developments tonight in a suspected drug smuggling plane crash in northern New Mexico. It happened just before 11 o'clock this morning at Heron Lake.
State police say the crash site is now a crime scene as they continue to recover sealed packages of cocaine floating up to the surface. Action 7's reporter Ana Velasquez is here with more details.
Investigators tell me the sealed packages of cocaine are about the size of a tissue box, and so far they have a couple dozen. Officials say it's possible there could be more once they take the plane out of the water.
Deputies blocked off the road around Heron Lake as the recovery effort for plane crash victims turned into a suspected drug smuggling investigation. Lonnie Henney says it was storming and didn't hear a thing.
It was raining and thundering so bad that you couldn't tell anything out of the ordinary.
Police say the plane crashed into Heron Lake just before 11 o'clock Sunday morning, and heavy rains and lightning forced officials to stop recovery efforts after the crash. Witnesses told police it looked like a fixed-wing aircraft, but it's not known exactly how many people were on board.
It's obvious that there was at least a pilot in there, but we don't know if there was any passengers with the pilot itself.
The plane sank beneath the surface, taking its pilot and whoever else on board with it. But within a few hours, its cargo began to surface, each one, police say, the size of a tissue box.
Right now, we have recovered several packages containing cocaine, and we have a crime scene active at this point.
State police are working to figure out who was on the plane, where it came from, and where it was going. Neighbors say low-flying planes are nothing new in the area.
We get tourists that come in, they buzz the lake. We get people circling around, traveling, you know, that come through and go by the lake.
State police say the dive team must go at least 100 feet below the surface to find the wreckage, and they expect to be on the scene for the next 48 hours.
In 2003, investigators came across a plane in Moriarty carrying a little more than $1 million. While it's not against the law to transport large amounts of cash, officials said it was highly suspicious and packed the same way for major drug deals.